and welcome to another video in our IP PoE Video Intercom series. So now things are starting to get a bit more complicated. We're going to have a single monitor setup, single doorbell setup with triple monitors. So this is not three separate flats, this is one flat where you're going to have three monitors, okay? So for example, you might have one in the main room, one in the kitchen, one in the bedroom. And you want them all to ring, obviously, when someone's at the door and they push the doorbell. Okay, so how do we go about doing this? We're going to obviously use IVMS 4200, but the way we set it up is we set up a main screen. So a main screen will be our initial screen. You could say the front room. And then the other screens are going to be set up as extensions to the main screen. Okay, so we'll quickly show you a live configuration, and then we're going to flip over to IVMS and show you how to configure it. So see you guys in a sec. Okay, so you see our setup here. We have three screens and our door station. So obviously it's not going to be working. I don't know if I'm getting anything out of this now.
Calling failed.
There we go, calling failed. Okay, so three screens all plugged into our switch, connected to the internet, just like any other setup. Okay, so now we're going to configure this on IVMS. So we'll flip over right now. Okay, so now we're into IVMS and we're going to configure our indoor screens. Okay, so you see here now we've got indoor screen 1, 2 and 3. We're going to make this one 1, even though it didn't say 1, we know it's 1. It's going to be our main screen, and then we're going to set up 2 and 3 as extensions to the main screen. Okay, sounds pretty easy, but it does require a few little parameter settings. So first things first, we go to our door station and we set our password like normal. Okay, so we go to intercom and we put in our password. Okay, so our door station configured, then we go to our indoor Wi-Fi screen. Okay, and then we go to network, group network settings. Okay, so we put in our password. Okay, and here it says main door station IP. So this is our doorbell, outside doorbell IP address, which has changed because of DHCP. So the door station here is 10.4.4.239. So this is actually what we put here, 10.4.4-239. Okay, so now this has linked our screen to our outdoor doorbell. Okay, and it says here room number 1. This is important for later, but we're just going to save this for now. And it's saved. Okay, so now we've linked it. Now we have to add an extension. So we now add an extension to our indoor Wi-Fi screen. So we go here, we go add. Okay, now you see it's asking for a lot of information. So how do we find this information? It's pretty easy. We go to our extension we're going to add, which is screen 2. And then you go to intercom. And then network. Okay, this is all, and then you find all the information here. You've got your subnet, mask, gateway, all here. I'm just going to copy the gateway for now, and then we go back to the indoor screen and we add our extension. Okay, so let's go to intercom extension, we add. So we add our gateway IP address. We get the IP address from up here, so that's 10.4.4.250. Okay, the serial number you get from the back of the device. So there's a little sticker on the back of your screen. Just grab that and put in the serial number. Oops. Okay, something that mail mask is two ways the same usually. Password as usual. And I'll just double check that. Okay, and this will be extension 1. Okay, so we go save. Oh, subnet mask is not valid. Okay, so we see 255. Perfect. Okay. Ah, error code. So we've got an error here. So let's just try again. Something's gone wrong. Let's try once more. So Q0564 Okay, the gateway, IP address. Try again. Adding successful. Okay, as you see it now, it's added it and we can see it added, but it says unregistered. This is normal. Okay, so we're gonna get it registered in a second. All right, so how do we do that? We go to our indoor screen too. It's intercom and network, group network settings. Indoor extension number one, we put in the password here and click on save. Okay, it's saved. So now we go back to our main screen, we'll see if it's registered. Oh no, it's under extension settings. Alright, registered. Now, perfect. That means it's been linked with our first screen, and now we just go add again. So we do this again for our second screen. So as you see, we're not adding to the second screen, we're adding to the main screen again as an extension. So your main screen is almost like the hub of screens if you have multiple stations. Okay, so let's do this one. IP address for our third screen is up here. Gateways are always the same. Okay, but this will be screen number two. Okay, so we go save. Okay, unregistered, that's fine. Then we go to our third screen. It's a network. Okay. As you see, it's a little bit different at the moment. Maybe it hasn't updated. Okay, let's just refresh this. Indoor screen 3 again. Okay, now you see it's updated. Okay, we're a little bit quick. First of all, screen number 2. That's exactly what we want to see. So we put in the password again. We click on save. Saved, and now we're going to quickly check it before we test it. And we should have two registered devices ready to go. Okay, two indoor stations, both registered, both set up to be extensions. Let's flip over to our live view and test it out. Okay, now we're in our live view, guys. So what we're looking for now is to push the buzzer and all three screens should ring at the same time. Okay, so let's give it a go. There we go. All three screens ringing, exactly what we wanted. Now we can go ahead and install them. All right. Alright guys, I hope you learned how to do a three-way extension now, and plus more, obviously more monitors you can add. And in the next video, we're going to show you how to set up the same setup, but for three different flats. Okay, so three screens, but three different flats. Hopefully see you then. Cheers. Bye-bye.